In this video, I'm going to solve this LP problem using Excel Solver add-in. When you click the data tab, you should see the solver add-in on the right here if you already have it installed. If it's not there, you can install it by going to File, Options, Add-ins, then at the bottom here, click Go, select the solver add-in and click OK. On a Mac, go to Tools, Excel Add-ins, Solver Add-in. When you now click the Data tab, you should see the Solver command on the right here. Now I'm going to place X1 here, drag to the right for X2 and X3. I'm going to shade the cells beneath them yellow. That's where I want the optimal solution to be placed. Next, I'm going to place the objective function coefficients on this row. 2.9, 1.9, 2.5. I'll start the constraints here. Copy down for 2 and 3. For constraint 1, the coefficient of x1 is 0, so we can either enter 0 here or just leave it blank. The coefficient of x2 is 3, and for x3, it's negative 1. For constraint 2, the coefficients are 1 for x1, and 1 for x2. For constraint 3, we have 3, 2, and 3. Next, we set up a formula for the objective function z. Recall that these yellow cells are set up to hold the values of x1, x2, and x3. Thus, the objective function will be the sum of the product of each coefficient and the yellow cell above it. I'm going to color this cell light green and use equals sum product, select the coefficients, comma, then select the variable cells. Enter. The value is 0 here because we are currently multiplying the coefficients by 0 in the variable cells. I'm going to color the constraint formula cells blue here, and again use equals sum product, select the coefficients, comma, then select the variable cells. This time I'm going to lock the variables down using the F4 key on Windows. On Mac, use Command T. You can also manually type the dollar signs. Use the fill handle to copy it down. And double-click it on the last one here shows that the formula copied correctly. Next, I'm going to place inequality signs for each constraint here. Greater or equal for constraint 1. And less or equal for constraints 2 and 3. The formulas in blue here represent the constraints left-hand side. For the right-hand side, we have 81 for constraint 1, 89 for constraint 2, and 400 for constraint 3. The setup is now complete. Now to solve this, I'm going to click on the Data tab, then click Solver. For the set objective, I'm going to select the objective function formula. For changing variable cells, select the yellow cells. To add the constraints, click Add. For constraint 1, click the left-hand side for cell reference. Change the sign to greater or equal, and select the right-hand side for the constraint value. Click Add. For constraint 2, select the left-hand side. The sign is already less than. In fact, both constraints 2 and 3 are less than constraints, so we can select both left sides at the same time. And also select both right sides at the same time. Since that's all the constraints we have, I can click OK. The added constraints appear here. Next, ensure that this non-negativity box is checked, and that the solving method is Simplex LP. Click Solve. The colored cells are now populated with values, with the optimal solution here and the objective function value here. You can stop there and click OK in this dialog box if you're only interested in the optimal solution. Otherwise, you can select whichever of these reports you want to see. I'm going to select all three and click OK. The answer report shows the optimal objective function value here. The values of the decision variables at optimal solution here, and if a constraint is non-binding, you will see a positive value for its slack or surplus here. You can also view the sensitivity report and limit reports here if needed. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.